Hey everybody, how's it going? My name is SockBot, and today we are doing yet another tip for create mode in Little Big Planet. Now, I'll put some little things here for the last two videos if you haven't seen them yet. If you haven't, I suggest you go watch them because I will probably reference them in this. But anyways, let's get started. So this is my three tips to making your level stay interesting throughout. Now, I don't want this to sound pretentious because I have this problem too. I'll be making a level and a few hours in, I'll be just bored to death of it. And you know, if I'm bored making it, I can only imagine how people will be bored playing it. So, thus, these are the three things that I have found make my levels stay interesting throughout, even if I have an interesting thing to begin with, and it kind of trails off. So, now, number one is, it's kind of the easiest thing to keep your level interesting, and this is kind of like the basis of you as a creator. Your job is to make the checkpoint-to-checkpoint basis of your level, if that's how your level is oriented, as most are, as interesting as possible. So, creating between the checkpoints, you want to make sure that you don't repeat stuff, but don't be afraid to repeat ideas. Now, I'm going to be showing in the background kind of just like a tutorial level here I made that was just kind of to represent some of these things and to show how to keep it interesting. So here I do actually repeat the same challenge a few times, but each time I add on to it or I alter it just a bit just to keep it interesting so it doesn't get boring halfway through and you're not doing the same thing over and over. Instead, you're doing similar things over and over, and it just gets harder each time. So that's a great way to, you know, keep it interesting. One challenge, and then the same challenge, but a little bit more difficult, and continue with that. Obviously, don't do this too much, or you'll lose your audience. But, yeah, so that's number one. Number two, and this is kind of something you might want to do from the beginning, or maybe just a little bit into your level if you can manage to make it make sense, and this is to add a gimmick. Now, this is a really important part of a level, because some people build entire levels off of one gimmick. In a lot of the story levels, there are different kinds of guns and different kinds of, you know, bippity-bops for Sackboy to carry around that are the gimmicks of that level, and that's why they're interesting, that's why they're different than anything else. So in this one, I've actually made a sort of gun by myself using the handle thing that lets you turn anything into a handle for Sackboy to hold, and it's kind of just like a little laser gun that shoots out bounce pads, and it's just a really simple thing. I doubt it would actually work very well in a real level, but here it is. And you know, other things you can do is you can do minor modifications, like say make Oddsock or give Oddsock the ability to grab onto things, and then there's a bunch of challenges that would be that would stem off of that, and you can go from there. Number three is to keep the level looking fun. Now, this isn't to reference any scenery, though that does help. This is to reference things like in the story mode, there are the layer launchers, which in most cases don't actually have like a strategic advantage. There's one puzzle in one of the games that requires you to move while going between foreground and background. But in, say, the Oddsock level, the first one you play as him, you're spending most of the level just going back and forth between the fourth ground and the background and the background and the fourth ground, just for fun, because it feels like you're flying and it's a good time. The velociporters are also used a lot like this, though there are more instances in which they are used as strategic puzzles to get past. The point of all of these fun obstacles that aren't really obstacles is to keep your player moving, to keep them feeling like they're flying or just getting somewhere throughout the level. Kind of like you need these to keep yourself interested in making the level. But anyways, that's number three. Let me know how you like it, and yeah, hopefully I'll make the fourth tip soon. But otherwise, yeah! Talk to you soon. Bye-bye.